Discussing about the design of the retaining wall. For the design of the retaining wall, there are following steps: calculation of forces, stability check, bending moment, shear force calculation, and the reinforcement design. Calculation of forces. There are two type of forces: resisting force and the overturning forces. Resisting force are because of the self weight of the soil and the wall, and the overturning forces are earth pressure, live load surcharge, and the crash barrier. Stability check. Stability check is for the sliding, overturning, and the base pressure. For the calculation of forces, we need to take the example design. Here we will be considering the height of the retaining wall. 2 meter height of the retaining wall, we will be seeing the design. Other dimensions are varying. As per the design, we can change. For the force calculation, we need to calculate the coefficient of the earth pressure as per the IRC 6/2016. Earth pressure will be acting on the wall from the soil. Here we can see the angle between the road surface and the wall is 0, and the wall and the soil is 90 degrees. So we will be calculating the earth pressure as per that, and we will be considering the angle of internal friction is 30 and the angle of wall friction is 20. As per these, we have calculated the active earth pressure and the horizontal and the vertical component of the same. Unit weight of the soil is 20 kN per meter cube, and the unit weight of the concrete will be 25 kN per meter cube. Resting force. Resting force are because of the self weight of the soil as well as for the wall and the vertical component of the earth pressure. Wall. Wall is of 2 meter height, 0.25 meter thickness, and we are considering the design for the 1 meter length of the foundation. Foundation is 0.25 thickness, 1.95 is the width, and 1 meter length. Self weight of the soil will be considering from the heel side. Toe side, it will give the stability, so we are neglecting that portion. Vertical component. So we have calculated the vertical force and the resisting moment about x. About x, x is the point here, toe. Because the overturning of the wall will be about O. Overturning forces. Overturning forces are because of the earth pressure and the live load surcharge. Earth pressure and the live load surcharge we have calculated here. The pressure is K gamma H. H here for the earth pressure is considered as 2.25. And the live load surcharge is also K gamma H. Here H is calculated as considered as 1.2 meter. And these are the weight. So we will be considering the forces. Earth pressure will be triangular loading, and the live load surcharge will be of the rectangular loading. So we are calculating the force as well as the moment. These are the horizontal forces which will slide the wall, and the overturning moment which will overturn the wall. Now check for the stability. Sliding check. Vertical load we have calculated at 89.52 and the horizontal force of 29.25. So here coefficient of the friction as per the IRC 78 between the soil and the concrete is 0.5. So the factor of safety is coming as 1.531, which is greater than 1.5. So it is safe in sliding. Overturning. Overturning moment we have calculated as 30.3 and the resisting moment is 90.1. So here factor of safety is coming as 2.971, which is greater than 2. So this is safe in the overturning and the sliding. As if these values are coming less than 1.5 or less than 2, so we need to redesign or change the dimension of the foundation and the thickness of the stem. Base pressure check. Base pressure will be checked against the center of the foundation. So total load on the foundation is 89.5 and the resultant moment will be equal to the resisting moment and the overturning moment. So here resisting moment will be of is of 90.1 and the overturning is 30.3. So here resultant moment is of 59.8. So this moment acts at a distance d from the x as 59.8 divided by 89.52 will be equal to 0.668. We need to consider these value from the center of the foundation. So we will be subtracting it from by the b by 2, which is 1.95 by 2 minus this d, which is coming out equal to 0.307. And so we will be calculating the moment v into e. V is 89.5 and the e value is 0.307. So this value is considered coming out to be 27.5. Now we need to calculate the base pressure. What is base pressure? Is P by A plus minus M by Z. P is 59.5, A is the area of the foundation, which is 1.95 into 1, as we are calculating for the 1 meter length. Moment we have calculated 27.5 here, and the section modulus. Section modulus is BD square by 6. Here B is 1, D is 1.95. So 1.95 square by 6, which is coming out to be equal to 0.63. So we are calculating P by A plus minus M by Z. There are two pressures, 89.3 and the 2. We are considering pressure at toe is 89.3 as the heel side there will be soil. The self weight and soil, pressure of the soil will be more at the heel side as compared to the toe side. So we are considering the more pressure at the toe side and the less pressure at the heel side. So here we have made the diagram for the, and we have calculated the pressure at a distance d from the toe side. Now we will be calculating the moment and the shear force as per this diagram. Area of this diagram will be the force, and the moment about the point we want to calculate the moment will be the moment. Here the calculation of forces for the toe length for the toe is 0.2, width 1, and the height will be the pressure diagram, pressure at that point. So we are calculating the forces as the area of the diagram and the moment as the area into the cg of that area from that point. We will be calculating the moment at the toe side and at the distance d from the support. So these are coming out to be 1.6, and the force, shear force, we need to design for the d distance. So 0.242. Heel, for the heel we need to calculate at the support only. So we will be calculating the moment and the force as per this. And this moment is coming out to be 24.1 and the shear force is coming out to be 15.5. These are the moments we need to design. As per the limit state, there is a factor of 1.5. So we have multiplied the forces with the 1.5 factor. So the reinforcement can be designed for these moments and the shear force. So we can design these moments and the shear force and the reinforcement for these moment and shear force. Thank you for watching the video. Please, if